I'm only kidding. I'll be there with my freshly laundered, multicoloured overall, paintbrush in hand.
Thanks. It's my turn to provide the food too, okay?
It's a deal.
Oh, John.
Morning.
We are very sorry to hear about your father.
Yes, Joan, my condolences. I never met the Major, but Meg told me what a fine man he was.
Thank you.
We didn't expect you back till the end of the week.
Yeah, well, I changed my mind. Might as well keep busy. Guess this is all I've got left now.
You got a blue or what?
Hey?
You and Marlene, what's up?
Wish I knew. Couldn't even talk to her this morning. I don't know what I'd done.
Mightn't be you at all, mate. This place would get anybody down. Might be just that.
No, it's more.
Eat up, it'll sort itself out.
Lexi.
Look, all I said was Matt was a hunk. Doesn't mean I'm going to race off with him.
Well, you have got a way of saying the wrong thing at the wrong time.
Up yours too. What's wrong with a lot of you today?
Some people might have problems, Lexi, and they don't need your smart comments on top of them.
Oh, forget that.
God. Now she's got a long face. It's catching. I think Eddie's the only one with anything to crow about today.
Hey, where the hell is she anyway?
I saw Mrs. M taking some gear into her. She must be getting changed for the big exit.
Yeah, it's nice of Mrs. Morris to take her in.
Yeah, if she is. That's probably only for a week or two anyway. The lady gets her own place.
Lou's giving us the evil eye. I hope your plan works.
So do I. Otherwise it'll be hard to get insurance. Oh, look at this!
Oh, hey. Lovely, eh?
Beautiful.
You know, I feel really happy for her, but it makes me hate this place even more, thinking how much time we have to serve.
Yeah.
Hey, Eddie. Is this for real?
Yeah, I told you I wouldn't forget, didn't I?
Oh, wow. Look, do you think you could change it to dollars for me?
Oh, there's no need to, dear. It's when they get out. They use real money out there, pounds, shillings and pence.
Yeah, but still, I'd rather dollars all the same.
Oh, well, if you want to, but won't do you any good when you get out.
You want to see me, Governor?
Yes, take a seat. How are you?
All right.
You feel up to work so soon after the funeral?
Yes, I'm fine, really. And thank you very much for the wreath. I really appreciate everyone remembering.
A lot of people here thought very highly of him, Miss Ferguson. Now, I'm sorry to have to bring this up at such a time, but this letter's been forwarded to me by Ray Proctor. You can understand my concern. The allegations against you are very serious. Did you try to force Proctor into injuring Keane?
Lies. You know what these animals are like.
It's not only Keane's signature. Proctor's a civilian.
Yes, well, that self-confessed drunk would have been pressured into it by Keane. And we both know that it's not the first time she's tried to have a go at me.
It wasn't presented until they both left Wentworth. I fail to see the point, if that's the case.
Well, all I can say, Governor, is that that cook had better stick to his trade, because trumped-up charges like this that could have been written by anyone would be laughed out of court.
In most cases, yes. But we've seen Keane, and she's prepared to confirm the contents. And Ray Proctor will back her up. This is just a copy, of course. I had no option, because of the seriousness of the charges, but to send the original to the department.
No, no doubt they'll soon see it for the fraud that it is, and that will be the end of the matter.
Yes, we'll see.
Will that be all, Governor?
Yes, but I suggest you be on your best behaviour until the department's finished its investigation.
Of course.
Sorry I'm late. Hey, get away from there. That's my job.
You don't work here anymore, Ed.
Oh, you can take my place then.
No, we're really going to miss you, Ed.
You know, it's habit, really. 45 years in the laundry, and now I'm going to have my very own child to do it. Oh, gee, I'm going to miss you all day.
You'll make lots of friends on the outside, Eddie.
Yeah, get Mrs. M to take you to the bingo and sing-alongs and stuff. You'll be right.
Oh, I never thought of that. Hey, look, will you give us that little Kelly girl? I forgot to give it to her before she went on kitchen duty.
Now, listen to me. This is all very generous of you, but you're going to need that money on the outside.
Yeah, look, we'll be right. Just you write to us to tell us how you're doing, eh?
That's right here. Have it back.
I didn't think you owed this much money. I mean, how did you get so much in debt anyway? Oh, look, I don't need it, but thanks very much for being so honest.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, Etty, didn't I tell you to stay in your cell?
Oh, hello, dear. I'm just saying my goodbyes.
Well, make it snappy. The department's car will be here shortly.
Oh, did you hear that?
Well, you deserve it, Etty. You go out there and make up for everything you've missed.
Woo, look out, fellas. Yeah, now you look after yourself, you hear?
Come along, Etty.
I'm coming, dear.
Don't forget to write.
No.
Three cheers for Etty. Oh. Hip, hip,
hooray!
What you're doing, Frank. We think it's fantastic.
Come along now, Mickey Pop.
Bye-bye. Good luck.
Oh, so Keane's causing trouble there too, is she? Right. Well, then I'm sure you won't mind giving me a hand with a little problem that I seem to have here, Cynthia. Huh? Good. I knew I could count on you.
And that's the one from the bank, so they'll let you draw on your funds.
Oh, thank you, dear. And this is for young Jan in the hospital. A little thank you note, you might say. And now we're getting along, eh? Been nice chatting with you, but I can't keep that nice young man waiting any longer.
Etty, the forms.
Oh. Just as well someone on their toes, eh?
Now, remember, Miss Hobson will be at the hotel in the morning to show you around the retirement villages.
What for?
Well, so you can choose where you're going to live.
And you think I've got a bad memory? I'm going to be living with you, remember? Just as well, too, by the sounds of it.
Will you shut up?
I'm sorry, Miss Ferguson.
I thought you'd have given up trying to play that bloody thing by now.
What? Is there something wrong with my music?
Oh, is that what you call it?
Listen, there's people around here that reckon my songs are pretty good, you know.
Oh, that lot, they're about as musical as they are intelligent. Anyway, we won't have to listen to your noise after tomorrow, will we?
Well, what do you mean?
Your trial, Brady. They throw the book at drug peddlers. And you're going to be back in here for a long, long time. And I will personally see to it that you never strum that thing again.
Etty, I am in the middle of moving into another flat. It's impossible for you to stay there. I am up to my neck in packing cases and redecorating.
Well, I'll be able to help. Oh, you poor thing, trying to do it all on your own. No wonder you've been a bit short of temper lately.
Etty, will you listen to
it's
me?
It's all right, dear. You don't have to explain to family.
You can't live with me. It just wouldn't work. Mrs. Reynolds has gone to a lot of trouble for
yes,
you.
Yes, she has. And you can't go against her wishes, dear. Now, come on. We can't let this young man wait any longer, can we, Jeeves?
It's all right. Plenty of time, Miss Putzler.
Oh, you're so kind. I'll just straighten Meg here on where the governor wants me to live and we'll be off.
Etty, you've got it all wrong. Mrs. Reynolds has arranged for you to stay in a hotel and that is where you're going.
You don't want me, do you? How could you be so cruel? If your mother knew that her only daughter was going to throw me out in the streets, she'd turn in her grave. Go away, Jeeves. I'd rather stay here with my friends.
It's all right, Etty. It's all right. Now stop crying.
I can't. I'm scared, Meg. I feel so alone.